Live Business, Ms. Sadia Haynes and Mrs. Kezia Charles. 5 Technical, Ms. Johan Annaville and Mr. Hector Mathre. 5 General, Ms. Duana Nicholas, who is on medical leave and cannot be with us this morning, and Ms. Helena Jonge. 5 Science, Mrs. Noelis Edgar Lord, Mr. Claude James, and Ms. Regan Butcher, who is not with us this morning as she is also on medical leave. Our Form 5 homeroom teachers. Graduating class for this year, 2020, ladies and gentlemen. Our most distinguished guest, District Representative for Castries North, Honorable Stevenson King.
Our esteemed District 2 Education Officer, Ms. Martha Foster.
Principal, Ms. Marva Daniel. Vice Principal, Mrs. Anne Gifford Elcock. And former Principal of Schools in District 2, Mrs. Janice Haynes.
Present and past teaching and non-teaching staff, members of CCSS and their spouses,
corporate sponsors, donors, specially invited guests, friends and well-wishers of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, representative from Civil Service Credit Union, Mr. Laura.
Executive members of the CCSS PGTA.
Parents and guardians, friends of the graduating class of 2020.
Friends of CCSS.
Members of our special band.
team providing videography and photography of this auspicious ceremony.
Our VIPs, the graduates, class of 2020. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome.
Amidst all the challenges of COVID-19, it is truly a great pleasure to welcome you to this auspicious annual occasion, the graduating of the class of 2020. It has been a challenge, but we are truly grateful to have you here. We welcome you, and we ask you to enjoy the ceremony.
It is with great pleasure and admiration that I welcome to you my co-host, Miss Constance Rennie, reputable teacher of mathematics and economics here at the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School.
And I welcome my co-host, distinguished teacher of English language and office administration, cheerleading coordinator of Oriole House here at Castries Comprehensive, Miss Saraya John. We welcome you and we ask you to just bear with us and enjoy the ceremony under the theme, Be Sanctified and Be Set Apart.
Thank you. We now call on Pastor Randolph to welcome the Holy Spirit and warm our hearts. Bless our ceremonies this morning.
Our kind and eternal Father, our God in ages past, our hope in years to come, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the health and strength you give all of us, including the administrators, teachers, parents, and students to have reached this day. We thank you for your graces that accompanied us along the way, and we ask in a very special way that you bless every graduate here today. You created them with a purpose in mind, and we ask, O God, that that purpose will be realized in the years to come. Continue to bless the parents who labored tirelessly during those 5 years and even before, and who need that divine push in the years to come to be the chief counselor and guide when those difficult moments come. Continue to grace them with your blessings and your goodness and your may your omnipotence and your omnipresent nature be evident with them as they traverse the days, months, and years to come. Bless the proceedings of this ceremony today. We ask that this sitting here would be one where your name would be glorified, honored, and exalted above every other name, we pray and ask in Jesus' name.
Amen. And after such a prayer, it's only fitting that we continue to give praise through song. We now invite our graduates to serenade us this morning with the song, Lord, We Thank You. It will be led by our principal, Miss Marva Daniel. Our honorable representative, Stevenson King. And before we go on with the song, Miss, I invite everyone to stand at attention as we sing our national anthem. Sing. Thank you. Graduands, you remain standing. And our praise and worship song, Lord, we thank you.
Graduands, we invite you to please take your seat. We now invite our esteemed principal, Ms. Marva Daniel, to give you the principal's address.
Let's put our hands together for our beloved principal, Miss Marva Daniel.
When one stands at a podium and has to adorn oneself with glasses, you know one's age, right? Our most distinguished guest, Parliamentary Representative for Castries North, Honorable Stevenson King. This gentleman we refer to as our godfather, has left an emergency meeting of cabinet members to be here with us today. So let's warmly welcome him again. Thank you, sir. Our esteemed, industrious, vivacious district education officer of District 2, Miss Martha C. Forster. Welcome again, Miss. An extension of your office, Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. To all our specially invited guests, Mrs. Prosper from class of 1985, Mr. Laura from Janu Credit Cooperative, welcome to our 44th graduation exercise. There are many of you here who wonder why there are these beautiful other persons on their right. And these, of course, are the mothers and fathers of your children, homeroom teachers of class of 2020. Let's, of course, give them a resounding round of applause for all their hard work. In the loft are some of our teachers, because the rest are busy working around the place. Our teaching staff, ancillary staff, administrative staff. And let's, of course, recognize the efforts of our night security, Mr. Elson Abraham, who never stops working at CCSS. Let's give him a round of applause for all his commitment to this school. Parents, we wouldn't be here if you didn't give birth to these wonderful offsprings of yours. So I bid you welcome and thank you again for all your efforts, all your hard work. Members of our band, welcome. Mr. Narcissus, Mr. Celestin, and of course, permit me to acknowledge the presence of two very, very special individuals. Finchite, Glenn Simon. Let's, of course, thank him and his other colleague, Oriolite Richmond Felix, who has allowed us to broadcast to the entire world. These two gentlemen have synergized to ensure that this occasion is viewed worldwide. So let's give them a round of applause, both past students. I know my staff are wondering how long will Ms. Daniel be this morning. But we've had an interesting 5 years, parents and friends. What a feat. What an accomplishment. Amidst all the unprecedented events that surrounded them, then and even now, we are here. So let's give ourselves a round of applause. We are back on site. COVID-19 forced us into what has been referred to as a new normal, a new balance, testing our resilience and, of course, our resources. But especially this week, we dated 2nd October as our graduation exercise, not even realizing how significant this date was. It fell on a week where we celebrate two remarkable sets of people, the archangels and guardian angels. For those of us who are Catholics, these feasts were celebrated this week. So students, you see how special you are? And of course, today is the first Friday of the month, a very important day of the week too, for those of us who are Catholics. But even more especially, so much is happening. I mentioned earlier that Honorable King has left an emergency meeting to be here. And so we've heard of the controversial health bill, which has been introduced to combat the coronavirus, and of course, to protect the citizens of this country. Hopefully, all stakeholders will engage and ensure that this bill speaks to our total safety. This week too, we have a possible Greek names system heading our way. And also this week is the scandalous financial budgets in the Vatican. We also have Dutch vegan food maker removing hurt in the word yogurt to ensure that persons are not hurt by any animal-based products. What an interesting week. We are indeed sanctified. We are able to present a sunset for our children that captures how blessed and set apart each of them are because they are God's creation. So we are indeed blessed. You are here at an institution like none other. And today marks one of the many decades of exercises held to mark the end of students' tenure with, of course, colorful accolades and an opportunity to reflectively cite all the memorable events that they and us were blessed with over the past 5 years. We have all struggled. And throughout the past half decade, we have tried our best to ensure that our staff, our students and parents could bask in the splendor of wonderful achievements that we accomplished over the past 5 years. COVID-19, you certainly could not take this joy away from us and dampen this opportunity. Our graduation this year is themed Sanctified and Set Apart, part two of our commissioning activity. It aptly allows us to reflect and, of course, to reassess carefully all of our actions and our very existence, and what a challenge these have been. Countless barriers impair our ability to function effectively, but still, as the cardinals we are, Oriolites, Heronites, Finchites, and Amazonians, and I hope I don't get licks for mentioning Amazonia last, we excel and forge towards excellence. We never give up. We never give up. Over the past academic year, our 32 subject areas cushioned within the distinguished academic, technical, and vocational areas allowed our students to graduate with a host of skill sets, knowledge, and training, poignantly ensuring employability and empowerment of all our graduates. Right here is an example. Glenn Simon and Richmond, past students. Remarkable accomplishments cannot go unmentioned. And so for this year, just a few. Our Form 3s, for example, and all math, English, and science teachers were gifted with a learn book, a project which was launched through the Ministry of Education. Through the efforts of the vice principal and her team, we launched what is called our Peace Corner. And today, as you entered, you saw the words peace. For the second time, we observe International Peace Day on 21st September. And so our Peace Corner before you leave here, visit it. You may find yourself more at peace. We twinned CCSS and Collège Elizabeth in Rivière-Salée, Martinique on 30th October 2019. And what a wonderful marriage this has been. Jeannot Credit Cooperative organized an interesting and exciting reality fair for both Form 5s and Form 4 students. Parents, I hope that you have seen our technical drawing lab. No other school on this island boasts such a well-equipped and perfect lab where students can learn technical drawing as per the industrial world. This lab was officially opened in the second term of the last academic year.
We experience improved and increased student management, subscription to the technical subject areas will increase, such as mechanical and technical drawing. These were outstanding subscriptions. And overall, we saw increased number of field trips and industrial training for students. And friends, the list goes on. At the external examinations this year, like last year, we successfully registered all our students for the regional examinations. Even those who didn't show up, we registered them. We also had a handful of students who registered and wrote the internationally recognized ACT examination. Rebecca, you could stand when I mention your name, Joshua, Melanie, Franklin, and the list goes on. So these students wrote the internationally recognized ACT, which markets them for college and for careers. How did we perform? Everybody wants to know how CCSS did, and of course, for comparative reasons. I beg to differ. CCSS compares to none other. No other school boasts the cadre of subjects that our curriculum offers. The 32 subjects written by students at CCSS, of course, allowed us to see 100% pass in 14, and I'm sure more after the queries have been registered and satisfactorily responded to. All of our subject areas, except for 5, attained over 70% pass rate. Come on, let's give the students and our teachers and new parents a round of applause. Marked improvements were registered in mathematics. All the technical subject areas attained 100% pass. Visual arts, 100%. And electronic document preparation and management not just attained 100% pass, but all students attained general 1 grades at this examination. Marked improvement in mathematics from 81%, 80.74, to 82.66%. Let's give them a round of applause as the Caribbean sadly announces the overall pass rate of 52%, not at CCSS. We have improved. Modern languages moved from last year's 43% to 64.47% average pass. Technical department from 98 to 100% pass rate this year. Among our graduates today are some students who successfully sat the CSEC exam in forms 3, 4, and now form 5. I want them to stand so you could see. One of those standing now who wrote in form 4, come on students, stand if you wrote your CSECs from form 3, 4, and now in form 5, of course, all of you. But those of you who wrote in forms 3 and 4, parents watch, guests watch. These are students who are proud enough to state that they are ready for the world. And among those standing is Franklin Bray, who wrote his exams, some of his exams in form 3, and currently continues as a student of CCSS and SALCC in form 5. Isn't that interesting? Historical. Let's give him a round of applause. So this student is in his second year of his CAPE studies at Sir Arthur Lewis Community College. Please stand, my graduates and graduates. So once again, our distinguished results attest to our very comprehensive nature. Thank you very much to the teachers who also allowed students to register in other forms for mechanical engineering and physical education and sport. All students passed these exams. And so, we move on from academics to our extracurricular activities. although we are challenged, challenged in various ways, and the dynamics of educating students continues to be challenging. For example, our teachers are constantly migrating to greener pastures. We bid farewell to two English department teachers this term only. Mrs. Janelle Shalry has moved on and migrated to the US. And now our beautiful English teacher, health fanatic, Miss Louis leaves us and has been recently appointed as the guidance counselor at the Stanley John Odler Memorial Secondary. Let's bid her congratulations and, of course, good luck in her endeavors. However, as we forge on, our industrial plan, of course, has been very successful in terms of allowing us to activate a learning platform which has been used before by few, but now by all, developed by our school's resource team over the past 4 years. At CCSS, we pride ourselves in having a host of digital platforms which allows us to engage with our students digitally and distantly. Quite an exciting blended approach that both staff and students have embraced awesomely. We saw last term over 95% of our students fully engaged during the third term, accessing our website, our email platform, our school's YouTube channel, and of course our colorful Facebook page. Some staff members can boast about their being upskilled and engagement with students. Our counseling department, in conjunction with the timetabling committee, established the first ever virtual subject selection process, which saw the timely selection of subjects by Form 3s and, of course, the timely provision of timetables for all of our students. Let's give Mrs. Elcock and her team a resounding round of applause. Pastoral care at CCSS also has been like none other. Through the efforts of our student support at the Ministry of Education, we were able to provide over 30 students with food packages. We also worked with the district councils to ensure that our at-risk students were catered for during the off-school period. The daily checks by our teachers and school administration enabled us to collaboratively keep abreast with our students' needs. CCSS was never locked down. Parents, did you hear me? CCSS was never locked down. And you know that. Our WhatsApp groups for parents and students was forever active. We opened all possible virtual lines of communication with everybody. Special thanks, of course, to the Social Development Fund. The program for our boys continued. And so during the lockdown, these boys were reached, they were cared for and provided for. And we thank Mrs. Anthony, I hope she's listening. Through her efforts, we know that our boys, and we knew even then that our boys should never be left behind. Additionally, the Ministry of Education's Digital Access Initiative saw over 20 students receiving digital devices, tablets, MiFi devices, all of these were provided to students to remain engaged. And through the efforts of our past student and St. Lucia Safe Spaces, Dr. Venus Cherry, they were able to furnish 7 of our students with tablets. Let's give them a round of applause. In sports, luckily we were able to launch our sports year and engage in annual sports meet such as our road race, our rammers in term one. And we were also able to close the curtains with outstanding performances in netball, track and field, and football. We still experience the painful moment when that final free kick was not free at all and cost us dearly in the finals to Vuefort. Such a heart-wrenching moment. The Benare Games may not be a competitive sport and not very popular, but for the second time, CCSS represented St. Lucia at the annual Amerindian Games in Martinique in May 2019. Additionally, three of our students represented St. Lucia at the first ever badminton clinic in Guadeloupe. Again, CCSS making St. Lucia proud. Successful and noteworthy is the selection of one of our very own current Form 5 students who has gained a full scholarship to study and play football in the US. Congratulations, Donovan. I hope you're watching at this moment. All our teams played marvelously. And Honorable King, take a bow. You helped to make this happen. Our girls were beautifully attired in their brand new netball uniform, thanks to Honorable King. Let's give him a round of applause for this effort. But sadly, as term two, which we will never forget, drew to midway, we saw the dreadful pandemic canceling all our sporting events and lockdown sports ensued. We started playing sports at sleeping, eating, and most especially, moodling. You didn't get the joke? CCSS Moodlers, let's big up the SRT, CCSS School Resource Team, which kept us fully engaged. Our physical education and sports teachers have to be commended. On Moodle, they kept students active, fit, and healthy. Even our FNN teacher, Mrs. Kodra, posted a challenge in nutrition, which was an activity and a quiz that we all engaged in. Our students also engaged in daily homeroom activities, weekly assemblies, Tuesday spelling, Wednesday worship, and all of these kept schooling alive throughout term three. Our Leo's Club members, their interest waned a bit, but thanks to the steadfast commitment of our parent, Mr. Emmanuel, we were able to engage in a number of meetings with parents to secure renewed interest and support from all of our students who are currently members of our school's Alpha Leo Club. Our student Chance Gabriel also represented CCSS at the recently held National Leo's Symposium. And as we return on site, students, parents, staff members have all adjusted to the new mode of operations. Our school year, although new, has been quite an adventure. And rotating is like none other. As I conclude, and of course try to present this milestone, a period ends this statement of 5 long years. A journey at CCSS ends for some of you, but so much more awaits you or has already started for those who are now working or pursuing further education. Be your best you, because you are sanctified. You are set apart. Everything you do should say this. Parents, thank you for your contributions, your support, your prayers, your patience, your suggestions, your involvement. Priceless. Indeed, we are all in this together. May God continue to sustain you, class of 1985. Who assisted some very special students to pay for their CXCs this year and have already committed to assisting 7 more students this academic year. Let's give them a round of applause. Janu, we await reality fair. And so as I end, I am challenging those of us who are here to continue to be our best. Now, my children, they smile sometimes when I say this, but get serious because, what did we do now? In your book, I've written to you my final goodbye as your principal. Indeed, the journey to this end has been phenomenal. You persevered to this end, and hopefully you can reflect on the past years with pride, joy, and thanks for the painful or painless sacrifices of all who ensued or ensured that you can now bask in this bliss of growth and glow in the splendor of years of achievement and great success. Students, just one little moment of pause as we remember Devin Pinder, who left us too soon, but gone to lay in peace. Dare to be different, but aim to be holy and solely you, because everyone else is already taken, students, and there's no other you. Someone once said that you will never influence the world by trying to be like it. You are trendsetters. You journeyed through a pandemic and survived. You are truly set apart and indeed sanctified with a wonderful new world ahead. Reach out, students, not just to the stars, but aim to walk closer and closer and closer to God, so that no space will be left for anything else. And as you stand erect in God's guidance and protection, everything will be possible. Arm yourselves with God's truth and remember, faithful is He who calls you, who also will do it. Remember that you are wonderfully made and very treasured. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Danielle. And after such promising, very promising statistics for the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, and after all our successes amidst the challenges for the 5 years, especially this year, it's only fitting that we make a little noise up in this place. So let's hear it for 5 vocational. Students, make some noise. 5 business. 5 technical. 5 general. 5 science. And all of us joining together, CCSS! CCSS! At this point, we call on our esteemed District Education Officer, Ms. Martha Foster, who will be assisted with our beloved Vice Principal, Ms. Anne Gifford Elcock, Mrs., to present our students with their certificates. We invite column 1, row 1, to stand. Kayla Achille. Carissa Albert. Kayla and Carissa also receive awards for being prefects. Kazima Alfred. Maki Alfred. Stacy Alfred. Karina Alphonse, who also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kisnil Anius. Imani Anthony. Kern Anthony. Jasani Antoine. Zai Antoine, who also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kizi August. Allison Augustine. Row 2, we invite you to stand. Johnny Augustine, Randy Austin, Taj Behari. Taj also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Jay Berthier also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Franklin Bray also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Hansel Butcher, Stuart Butcher, Natania Snack also receives an award for being a prefect. Rebecca Shalry, Chelsea and Charles also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Omeka Charles, Trenise Charles also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Josiah Charles, Jenna Chico. Kenny Clark also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Sindel Clark. Shakira Clement. Annabelle Cornibut also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Cherise Delair. Jean-Baptiste De Leon. Tyler DeMarc also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kayla Daisy, Shane Diodoni, also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Joshua Duncan also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Lisi Edward also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Tamika Estefan.
Why is he in that row, on that row?
Okay. Shemaya Eugene also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Neva Fannis also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Row 4, we invite you to stand. Kid. Tomia Fatal, Naya Felix, who also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kedani Felino also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Cachelle Fevrier also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Shaunita Fevrier also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kayla Florence also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kaylan Fontenelle. Faith Gustav also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Abigail Harris. Michaela Henry also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Faith Ann Hilleman receives a certificate for being a prefect. Ashley Hippolyte. RJ James prefect. Receives a certificate for being a prefect. Thank you. Kelly James. We invite row 5 to stand. Sydney James. Owonja Baptist. Tasha Jamarie. Tasha Jamarie receives a certificate for being a prefect. Tiffany John also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Nyan Jonas. Gabriella Joseph also receives a certificate for being a prefect.
Nothing is impossible.
Keisha Joseph.
Nothing is impossible.
Laricia Joseph receives a certificate for being a prefect. Naomi Joseph. Shaquan Joseph. Shayna Jules. Melanie Lamontine also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kasim Lorenzen. Michaela Mathre.
Nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible.
Anu Lenny also receives a certificate for being a prefect. We invite row 6 to stand. Enya Marty. Enya receives a certificate for being a prefect. Phoebe Marty. Abigail Mitchell. Aria Mitchell. Nathaniel Michelle also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Elijah Montoot. Nehemiah Monrose. Ashley Mooner also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Roshan Natram also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Patrice Nicholas. Kira Odlam. Kira also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Zoe Polio. Megan Prosper also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Jassan Prosper receives a certificate for being a prefect. Megan Prosper. Rigobert.
Nothing is impossible.
We invite row 7 to stand.
Nothing is impossible.
Devonte Reynolds. Melanie Richard. Melanie also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Melanie Richard. Shrenice Ross. Kasama Samuel. Kasama also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Sharicia Simon. Jaira Scotland. Jaira Scotland. Mary Claire St. Omer. Mary Claire also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Katsia Sylvester. Alicia Stephen.
Nothing is impossible.
Davia Stephen.
Nothing is impossible.
Jemiah Thomas. Jemiah Thomas also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kayla Thought also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Kelly Trim also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Lisa Valsin. Valsin. We invite row 8 to stand. Terry Valsin. Khadija Victor also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Shefran Wilkie. Ola Williams. Ola also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Shania Wilson also receives a certificate for being a prefect. Val Yard. Sandy Wilfred. We thank you, esteemed District Education Officer, Ms. Marva Foster, and our beloved Vice Principal, Mrs. Elcock. Thank you so much. Thank you, students. At this point, we call on our graduates who will grace us with their lovely presentation. Before we move on to our graduates' presentation, we would like to present our district education officer with a lovely bouquet of flowers. Thank you so much, Miss, for always gracing us with your presence. Thank you. Thank you once again. And now, our VIPs, we call on you to bless us with your lovely voices this morning as you are led by your principal, Ms. Marva Daniel, with your graduation song. Led by Mr. Narcissus.
Again?
CCSS, you can jig to the graduation song like this. Memories bring back, memories bring back. Oh, CCSS. Oh.
Thank you very much, graduates. That was an excellent rendition, and I think they deserve another round of applause. Okay, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our valedictorian for the graduating class of 2020. She is the first from the technical department. She was a very dedicated student. She served on the Students' Council. She worked well academically. And she also served as a prefect. So with great pleasure, I am pleased and feel privileged to introduce this year's valedictorian, Ms. Shamaya Eugene.
Hello, everybody. You all look so beautiful. Look at y'all. Okay. Please permit me to adopt the protocol already established. I bid you all, esteemed guests, parents and guardians, principal, staff, and especially my fellow graduates, a marvelous good morning. This is a day we have awaited with great anticipation. The day we celebrate the culmination of our tenure here at our beloved Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. Today, we the graduates say goodbye to an institution that has molded us in numerous and significant ways. Here, we have received valuable knowledge, skills, and right attitudes. Here, our minds and spirits have been formed for success in our future endeavors. Here, we faced many challenges throughout our 5 years, both individually and as a school family. But through it all, we prevailed, we conquered, we were victorious. So, as we sit here this morning, looking spectacular, with our hearts full of joy, I say to you, my fellow graduates, that we deserve every ounce of happiness that we feel today. Let us celebrate our achievements and know that the future is in our hands. In fact, permit me to stress that it is not just the future, but the present too is ours. Our time is now. From today, we shall start creating our legacy. As we entered into this year, 2020, little did we know that it would have been a year of much drama. Yes, we were filled with anticipation, believing that this would be the year that would catapult us into our destiny and into a new era. Even as the world began to tremble with the news of a new and dangerous virus, we could have never imagined that this virus would creep into our society, our world, and have such a dramatic impact on our final months of secondary school life. How could we have imagined that our CSEC exam schedule would be turned upside down and that we would begin our examinations at a time when such exams are usually completed? How could we imagine that we would be sitting these exams under the anxiety of a new COVID-19 protocols? The full online mode for this exam was new too. We were the guinea pigs. Even as this pandemic wreaked havoc around the world, we had no choice but to face the pressures of extended online classes and lengthy periods of study and revision. Remember all of those late nights before COVID? Well, I don't. We had it good. COVID. Sleep? What's that? A brick? Never heard of it. Our parents' light and electricity bill? Gone through the roof. Online classes were gruesome. Preparing for CXC? Dreadful. Making matters worse was the isolation of having to stay at home 24/7. Absolutely horrific. It was a major challenge, my fellow graduates. But guys, we did it. Our success would not have been possible, however, without the support of our remarkable teachers. They deserve all the recognition they can get for their commitment to our learning. The Zoom calls and Google meetings were endless. Our phones were never silent with the constant practice exercises and notes and discussions, all of which increased our level of preparation for the ultimate exams. Without the sacrifices of our teachers to equip themselves with the necessary tools, skills, and materials to shift from on-site learning to online classes, we would have strayed. And so, on behalf of the entire 2020 graduating class, I say a heartfelt thank you to all of our teachers. We really do appreciate you. Ms. Daniel, our dearest principal, how could we ever forget you? With you, there was never a dull moment as you held us spellbound with your presence, your guidance, and your daily motivation. We are more than impressed with your efforts to adjust to a new mode of teaching and learning as you ensured that the new learning platforms met the needs of all of your students. We really do appreciate and love you, Miss. And from the bottom of our hearts, we say thank you. To our esteemed Vice Principal, Mrs. Elcock, your efforts did not go unnoticed as you stood alongside Ms. Daniel and ensured that your students were on par with the new learning platform. Ms. Busybody, a name bestowed upon her because she was never found in her office, but somewhere around the school, teleporting to her desired destinations. We will miss you, Mrs. Elcock. On behalf of the graduates here today, with our hearts full of gratitude, I say thank you. My fellow graduates, let's take a walk down memory lane, shall we? The 4.5 years that we spent within the walls of this excellent institution were stupendous. Where did the time go? The memories we made and the bonds of friendship we forged will never be forgotten. How will we ever forget the achievements, medals, prizes, and trophies acquired by our very own? Whether it was in sports, in academics, in technical skills, in talents, you name it, and yes, we excelled. There were students like Annabelle, Franklin, Melanie Richard, Anu, and Tyler, dominating the sciences. Khadija, Jamaya, and Sindel conquered all aspects of business. Stars like Laricia and Michaela could solve math problems with their eyes closed. Let's not forget Imani, Joshua, and Zoe, mastering the English language better than the British themselves. Jean-Baptiste was a master in the technical subjects. Natania breezed through Caribbean history. Charissa mastered drama. And there were beautiful doses of Picasso's art from Enya and Charissa. These are just some of those who pursued excellence in the classroom. We were not to be outdone on the field of play either. Jay mesmerized his opponents on the basketball court. Kedani was a goal-scoring machine, and McKenny and Zai dominated the cricket pitch. Our form level even featured women's footballers, including Jasani, Kira, Natania, Melanie L, and Melanie R. In netball, there were Taj and Stacy. In volleyball, we were dazzled by Shestrenis, Omika, Nia, and Jasan. Heating up the tracks were Kayla Thorpe, Kizzy, and Shefran. Do you understand now the multi-talented nature of this graduating class? CCSS is indeed the best. Oh, how I'm going to miss Miss Claire's and Miss Maggie's delicious food. It was a joy each day to shout, "Miss Betty, a 150 local and 2 sausage rolls," to which she would reply, "Whoa, kisaki we visiting mama isala. Take your time." There was never a dull moment in the race to buy food. Well, except for when there wasn't any. "Can I get a glass of ice, please? That's $1, so I have to pay for ice." I'm sure we all know who I just quoted. A little laughter for the day with Zoe. The conversation was always predictable. Among the most memorable seasons at CCSS was term 2, sports season. The inter-house rivalry was always intense, and the tension could be cut with a knife. We could always count on Mrs. Lord to remind us all. Beginning with CCSS traditions like fun sports and rammers, simple fun activities such as needle and thread, balloon bursting, and late for school would quickly transition into much more serious competition. Seeing who can swallow the burn hole and who cannot, or to see me get dragged across the auditorium floor like a rag doll in tug of war. The video is still somewhere, but like I said, intense. Let's talk about marathon. Waiting on our toes to know whether Heron avenged first again or not. Let's not talk about cheerleading, because we all know who the champions are. Amma? All right, that's what I thought. Our trips to the stadium were always exciting, in contrast to the tension felt whenever Kizzy or Kayla was on the track. Remember the infamous cake days? Regardless of what house we belonged to, we would move from room to room like a family on Christmas Day, celebrating and enjoying the delicious treats from other houses. Let's be honest, Oriole House is known to have the prettiest of cakes. And the most. Rumor has it that there is still some left over in the freezer from last year. It's true. And yes, Miss Danielle, we know what house you in. There were many fun times in our 5-year experience at Castries Comprehensive Secondary School, but we worked just as hard. We remember the break and lunch times that we remained stuck in class completing work. Science students will remember how we sacrificed our lunchtime break just to get labs done. At least there was entertainment. Thank you, Mr. James. Scattered around the school will be other students working diligently to complete assignments or studying ahead for 6th period. Who knows, these teachers were so unpredictable. Pop quiz here and pop quiz there, a never-ending pop quiz. But anyways, thank you, teachers. Yes, Compre was sweet, but the real world is knocking on our door. Speaking of which, can you imagine that many of us have recently found ourselves enrolled in 2 schools at once? We are Sir Arthur Lewis Community College students while not yet having graduated from CCSS. Add that to the list of chaos things added in COVID-19. When I would say that I was going to my school, someone would ask, which one? I'd be left dumbfounded until I remember, oh right, now there's still Alpha. Ebebo. But CCSS will always be our school. As we come to the end of our secondary school journey, I encourage you, my peers, to set goals and keep pursuing your dreams. Believe in yourselves. We are unstoppable. Take a look at Kalen. He sustained a broken jaw in a vehicular accident, and 1 week later, wrote CSEC exams in math and English, conquering both. If this does not scream determination, I don't know what does. Wow, remarkable job, Kalen. As the CCSS graduating class of 2020, we owe a huge debt of gratitude to our parents and guardians, teachers, true friends, and all others who stood by us and gave us motivation. My fellow graduates, I ask all of you to stand and join me as we say thank you to our... Thank you, Stan. Yes, guys. My fellow graduates, let us give them all a resounding round of applause. Yes, thank you, parents. We really appreciate you guys. Because without their motivation, we probably would have just stayed in our room and look at the laptop and not do the work and whatever, whatever. So parents, thank you. You can sit down. Let's not forget to thank our Heavenly Father, for without Him, nothing would have been possible. We are now ready to take this and take on this world and show them what we've got. Now, my peers, as we graduate today, I bid you all good luck and success in your upcoming ventures. And remember, winners never quit and quitters never win. Class of 2020, we did it. Thank you.
Shamaya Eugene, thank you so much. And this is the stuff that CCSS is made up of. Young men and women of brains. Thank you so much. At this point, we have a musical presentation by our graduates.
Yeah. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
I believe I can fly.
job. Excellent job. This is testimony to the music program, the successful music program we have here at CCSS. And when you hear that kind of singing, you too believe you can sing. So I made up my own song. I believe I can sing. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss John. We now move on to the presentation of awards. We invite a representative from each of the departments. First, we begin with the business department. Representative from the business department to present the subject awards for business. Okay, Ms. Shalry is on. The awards are presented to the most outstanding students in the various subject areas. We begin with principles of business. Principles of business. Okay, so we have Mrs. Charles. The award for Principles of Business goes to none other than Franklin Bray.
These proficiency prizes are awarded to students' overall performance in the specific subject area and has been outstanding during the last three academic years. The student's behavior must also be given due consideration.
Thank you, Ms. Frederick. The second award is for the subject of principles of accounts, and this subject goes to Khadija Victor. We have the award for office administration, and that award goes to Jemiah Thomas. Khadija, don't go too far. Award for information technology, and that goes to Khadija Victor. We have the award for electronic document preparation and management, formerly known as typing. That award goes to Nathaniel Mitchell. We have the award for economics, which rounds up the business department. We have that award going to Phoebe Marty. Thank you. And the most outstanding award for the business department, the most outstanding student in the business department, goes to none other than Khadijah Victor. Congratulations, Khadijah. We invite a representative from the technical department for the next set of awards. Okay, thank you, Ms. Charles, and all the other business teachers for your outstanding work in the business department. Okay, we have Mr. Mathre from the technical department presenting the next category of awards. We have technical education, most outstanding student in the auto mechanics department, Jasan Prosper. Congratulations, it's nice to see a female coming up for the Tech Auto Mechanics Award. Jasan. The award for agricultural science goes to Tasha Jamari. The award for building technology goes to RJ James. Award for electronics and electrical technology goes to Nathaniel Mitchell. The award for technical drawing goes to Jean-Baptiste De Leon. The award for mechanical engineering technology goes to Franklin Bray. The award for physical education and sport goes to Kayla Thorpe. For the most outstanding student in the technical department goes to RJ James. Congratulations, RJ. Well done. Mr. Mathra. We now move on to the Modern Languages Department, and we call Ms. Annaville to present the awards. The award for Spanish goes to Annabelle Cornibut. Congratulations, Annabelle. The award for French goes to our valedictorian, Shamaya Eugene. Congratulations, Shamaya. Annaville. We now move on to the mathematics department, and we call Ms. Vidal to present the award. Ms. Quintina Vidal. The award for the most outstanding mathematics student goes to Franklin Bray. Ms. Vidal. We now move on to the English department, and we call on Ms. Janice Frederick to present the award. I had to do justice to her name. Okay. The award for English A goes to Shrenice Ross. Congratulations, Shrenice. The award for English B goes to Rebecca Shallery. Congratulations, Rebecca. Ms. Frederick. We now move on to the Social Sciences Department, and we call Ms. Jonge to present these awards. Okay, the award for social studies goes to Melanie Richards. This would be Congratulations, Melanie.
This could be amazing. Hey, DJ, can you play that?
The award for history goes to Jamiah Thomas. Congratulations, Jamiah. The award for geography goes to Joshua Duncan. Congratulations, Joshua. Thank you, Ms. Jonge. We now move on to the vocational department and we call Ms. Daisy to present the award. Okay, the first award is for textiles, clothing, and the fashion. And that award goes to Michaela Mathurin. Congratulations, Michaela. The next award is for food, nutrition, and health. That award goes to Melanie Richard. The next award is for visual arts. That award goes to Jaden Eugene. Jaden, the next award is for visual arts craft. That award goes to Kasama Samuel. Award is for music, and Shrenice Ross is the recipient of that award. Congratulations. The next award is the Theatre Arts Dance. That award goes to Jamiah Thomas. Yeah. The recipient of the award for theater arts drama is Ashley Hippolyte. Congratulations, Ashley. Now we have the award for the most outstanding student in the vocational department. And the recipient of that award is Michaela Mathre. Congratulations. Thank you, Ms. Daisy. We now move on to the Natural Sciences Department. We call on Mr. James to present the awards for physics and chemistry. The award for physics and chemistry, the most outstanding student in physics and chemistry, goes to Franklin Bray. He gets both physics and chemistry. Congratulations, Franklin. Very impressive. Thank you, Mr. James. We now call on Ms. Lord to present subject awards for biology and integrated science. The award for biology goes to Franklin Bray. Congratulations, Franklin. And the award for integrated science goes to Sindel Clark. We now move on to the most outstanding science student, the most outstanding student in the Natural Sciences Department. Ms. Lord, for presenting that segment of awards, and we invite Ms. Lauren Prosper to present the next category of awards. The next set of awards, sorry. So that award she's going to present is to the best science student. The most outstanding science student. The award for the most outstanding science student goes to none other than Franklin Bray. Congratulations, Franklin.
Thank you, Ms. Prosper. Our next award goes to the most academic student. For this category, the student who has performed in at least 5 academic subjects and has been outstanding during the last 3 years. Student also has the highest overall GPA. To present this award, we call on the Honorable Stevenson King. Our minister will remain on to present these prestigious awards.
The award for the most outstanding academic achievement for the class of 2020 goes to none other than Franklin Bray. Congratulations. To the special awards, and we begin this set of awards with the sports awards. We now call on the recipient of the Netballer of the Year, who is Miss Taj Bihari. Taj Bihari. The award for Cricketer of the Year goes to Zai Antoine. Congratulations, Zai, and to the other awardee. The award for Footballer of the Year goes to Danny Fennell. The award for Male Track and Field Athlete of the Year goes to McKinney Clark. Congratulations. The award for Female Track and Field Athlete of the Year goes to 2 persons, Kayla and Kizzy August. Congratulations. year goes to Nia Felix. The award for Basketballer of the Year goes to McKenny Clark.
The Best Science Award, which was presented earlier, is the Urban Prairieville Award, Class of 1985. Thank you.
The award for cycling goes to Melanie Richard and Zai Antoine. Melanie Richard and Zai Antoine. Move on to the sportswoman, or should I say sportswomen of the year, and the sportsmen of the year. We have the sportswomen of the year. The first sportswoman of the year is Kayla Thorpe. The second sportswoman of the year is Kizzy Auguste. Congratulations to our Sportswomen of the Year 2020. Our Sportsmen of the Year, the first of the two, McKenny Clark. The second Sportsman of the Year is Zai Antoine. Thank you, Honorable Minister. We invite you to stay on. We will be presenting you with a token of appreciation. We now move on to another set of special awards. We invite our distinguished district education officer, Miss Martha Foster, to present.
Hi, Uncle Bernie.
Award for Most Improved Student goes to Randy Austin.
For Most Improved Student, student must have an overall grade. Overall grades have improved over the last 3 years. Behavior and deportment have also improved over the last 3 years. Congratulations. Next award is the Most Dedicated Student. Student whose application has been consistent in all subject areas. Behavior must also be considered.
And that award goes to Franklin Bree.
Congratulations, Mr. Bray. Most disciplined student, male and female. Student whose behavior has been consistently exemplary. Such students should have a clean record in terms of behavior, student regularity and punctuality, and his or her timely completion and submission of assignments must also be given due consideration.
The most disciplined male student is Nathaniel Mitchell. And the most disciplined female student is Annabelle Cornibut. Thank you.
Sorry. That's it.
Thank you, Miss Foster. We now call upon our esteemed Vice Principal, Miss and Mrs. Ann Elcock,
to present.
No.
Most consistent student. Student who has displayed most consistent behavior and performance over the past 3 years.
The two students who are recipients of this award are the male student, Franklin Bray, and the female, Annabelle Cornibut.
Most persevering. Most persevering. Student who has been consistent despite challenges.
The two students who receive awards in that category are Melanie Richard and RJ James.
We're gonna walk it out and move.
The Cornelia Langala Award, Perpetual Prize, All-Round Dedication and Perseverance. Student has been most dedicated to his or her studies and persevered throughout his or her tenure.
And the Cornelia Langelier Award goes to Anu Lenny. Principal. We invite Mr. Laura from Janu Credit Union to present the next award. The next award goes to the best saver. For the class of 2020 is Hannah Rigobert. Mrs. Elcock, we need you back on stage for just a little while. Thank you, Mr. Laura. Mrs. Elcock will be presenting the award for contribution to school life.
Contribution to school life. Student who has been the most affable and connected with most, if not all, students through the 5 years.
The recipient of that award is McKenny Clark. Mrs. Elcock. We now call on our esteemed principal, Miss Marva Daniel, to present the next set of awards. Just before we announce the next set of awards, we'd just like to thank Miss Dahlia Phillip and Colby Samuel for contributing to the Sportsman and Sportswoman of the Year awards.
Parents, every year it's my task, because it's always difficult, to select an individual who exemplifies what I would describe as the most well-rounded individual. And so the certificate that this individual receives says, 5 years of steadfast discipline, humility, commitment to her or his studies, and of course, exemplary deportment, exceptional personal pride, outstanding punctuality, and generous
with time and talent. Before I do so, of course, I would like to single out one or two parents who, from Form 1 to 5, were always present to give of their time, treasure, and talent. And I'd like Miss Santoma, Mary Claire's mom, to stand. And this lady will be receiving an 80-minute spa treatment at Calabash Cove Deep Tissue Massage for all your years of commitment. All the June Quayols in the kitchen, on the grounds, assisting and giving and giving and giving of your time, your talent, on your trainer. That's from you, miss. Thank you so much, Miss Santoma. I'd also like to single out another parent who, when our phones were down and, you know, I just make one call. Any electrical problem with our telecommunication network, and this parent would be there. From Form 1 to Form 5, supportive again. Miss Allison Tibet, please stand. You too get that prize of an 80-minute massage at Calabash Cove. I'd just like to thank these parents. You made so much happen for us. And so now, the Principal's Award. So I always give Principal's Award to parents and to students. This little girl, we have admired from Form 1 to Form 5. And as the certificate said earlier, quite exemplary. And throughout the 5 years, I've monitored her steadfastness and humility. And it gives me great pleasure to present the Principal's Award to none other than Annabelle Cornibert. Annabelle receives from me an A31. That's a brand new branded cell phone. Thank you very much. And now, join me on stage, Honorable King, our godfather, daddy of CCSS. We call on him for everything and he always delivers. And right now, the Student of the Year Award. Help me, MCs, to describe this individual. And you saw it. This person got the most awards. Is that true? Even if he came last, he would represent his house in sports. He was the head prefect, you know. And I think everybody, we don't even need a criteria. It speaks for himself. The most auspicious award given today goes to none other than Franklin Bray, Student of the Year, Class of 2020. Presented by Honorable King. Represented CCSS in Science Fair, Science Quiz, a peer helper. Contributed significantly in student management. Very mature individual, even if he came in Form 2 as the shortest student. Still very disciplined, so mature for his height and his age. He has such a positive attitude. Even when his own teachers were despondent, he gave them encouragement. Let's give him a round of applause. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ms. Frederick. we need to call security to escort Franklin with all that gold. Congratulations, Franklin. Well-deserved award. Thank you, Honorable Stevenson King, and all of our presenters. Congratulations to all our awardees. And we just want to encourage those who may not have gotten an award, all of you are winners. All of you have finished school under peculiar circumstances. You were in a situation that none of us have faced before, and you did exemplary. And I want you to give yourselves a pat on the back, and I wish to congratulate all of you one more time. Every single one of you are winners. Okay? We have come to the end of the awards. We now call on our salutatorian, a very long word, salutatorian, to deliver our vote of thanks. I call on Shane Diodone to deliver our vote of thanks.
Good day, everyone. Permit me to adopt protocol already established. I am Shane Diodone, and it is indeed an honor to deliver this year's expressions of gratitude at this esteemed graduation ceremony. CCSS, class of 2020, we did it. We have conquered and made history. We have been sanctified and set apart. Look back at September 2015. Wow, what a milestone. We have made great accomplishments at this prestigious institution. And for this, we are grateful. Today, we live here as graduates in the midst of a global pandemic, COVID-19. William Arthur Ward states, feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. We must recognize and express our gratitude to all those who made our dreams become realities. Firstly, to God, our Heavenly Father, who has guided us and protected us from all harm. He promised us in Isaiah 41 verse 10 that we should have no fear, for he will help us. Today, we are here, testimony of his promise to us, and we say, thank you, Lord. A special thank you to our distinguished parliamentary representative for Castries North and minister responsible for infrastructure, energy, and labor, Honorable Stevenson King, for gracing us with your presence and assisting with the presentations of the awards. Your assistance over the years has been greatly appreciated. A special thank you to our district education officer, Ms. Martha Foster, for presenting our special awards today. Question: where would we have been without our great captain and her team? Thank you to our remarkable principal, Ms. Marva Daniel, and awesome team of compre teachers who directed us along the right path and gave us a solid foundation for a successful future. Thank you for instilling positive values in us and ensuring that we developed an appreciation for doing our best. 3 cheers for our principal and her team. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Thank you. To all the non-teaching staff of CCSS, thank you for being part of building our memories. We will indeed miss you, especially shouting, Miss Betty, my bacon cheese at 150 local. Compre days. We say thanks to the school's band, the school's music teacher, and also Mr. Muni for videography and photography. And to our graduates, such as Melanie Richard and company, for your contributions today. We say thank you to the sound management team. We heard everything. Special thanks to our religious education teachers, especially Pastor Randolph and graduate Franklin Bray, for praying with and for us today. To you, our wonderful parents and beloved family members, we could never have come this far without you. Thank you for the pressure, the love, support, and encouragement you gave us. Thank you for all the sacrifices you have made to ensure we had 5 successful secondary school years. Thank you. To the school's Parent Teacher Association, we say thank you. To the CCSS Graduation Committee of 2020, thank you for making it happen for us. Wow, you guys have put in so much hard work and dedication to make today a reality. We are indeed grateful. Special thank you to our digital team, Mr. Glenn Simon and Mr. Richmond Felix, for capturing our spectacular event. Let me, on behalf of the graduating class of 2020, thank sincerely all the companies, individuals, and other organizations who were instrumental in the provision of gifts, donations, assistance, and support, which made our celebration a success. Special thanks to the St. Lucia Civil Service Credit Cooperative for the donation of the award to the best saver. Graduates, thank you for the good behavior today. And as difficult as it has been to prepare for today, we triumphed and we made it to today. Round of applause to yourselves. Thank you, Shamaya, our class valedictorian, for your presentation. You surely captured our moments over the past 5 years and encouraged us to really look to this day. Thank you once again to all our distinguished invited guests who took time to share in our celebration today. We are truly blessed and even more grateful that we have been sanctified and set apart. Invited guests, principal, teachers, parents, and CCSS class of 2020, I encourage you to always remember the words of Brian Tracy. Develop an attitude of gratitude and give thanks for everything that happens to you. I thank you.
And it's our turn to say thank you, Shane, and remain on stage. Shane, remain on stage. And we invite Shamaya to join Shane, Shamaya Eugene, as we present you with certificates. Thank you, Ms. Frederick, for presenting to our students.
Our salutatorian, Shane Diodone, and our valedictorian, Shamaya Eugene. Thank you. Congratulations. We now invite everyone to stand as our graduates sing the school's anthem. This is the first that you will sing the school's anthem as a group.
It will be my pleasure to raise my school anthem. Look to this day, for it is life, the very life of life. In its brief course lie all the verities and realities of your existence. The glory of action, the splendor of achievement. For yesterday is but a dream, and tomorrow is only a vision. But today, well lived, makes every yesterday a dream of happiness. And every tomorrow, a vision of hope. Look well, therefore, to this day. Such is the salutation of the dawn.
Wow, that was beautiful. We now invite our student of the year. We ask you to remain standing as we invite our student of the year, Mr. Franklin Bray, to lead the closing prayer.
Catholics and yourselves. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this beautiful day, a day in which we gathered here to celebrate together as the class of 2020. Lord, we thank you for the many successes that we've experienced through our CXC examinations despite the difficulties of our pandemic and all the issues surrounding it. You saw us through and gave us success for our hard work. Lord, we pray asking at this time that you continue blessing our alma mater and the teachers who have dedicated their lives to serving and shaping the young people of St. Lucia for their futures. Lord, class of 2020 is in your hands. We pray that you may bless us and guide us through our lives. Bring us more success, and let us always remember that our blessings come from you. This is our humble prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Franklin. We now invite parents to turn facing your child or your ward. We present to you the graduates of the class of 2020 of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. Congratulations. We encourage you to be sanctified and be set apart as you commence another chapter in your journey. Parents, you may have your seats. Maybe seated as we invite our principal and vice principal to lead the final procession of our graduates, not graduands. You are no longer students of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. You are past students of the Castries Comprehensive Secondary School. Congratulations. Congratulations. This is indeed a marvelous accomplishment, and you should all be proud of yourselves.
Just a side note, MAP students from Miss Labontagne, she asked that you return to the auditorium after the procession. Or right, you come up for your awards after the procession, and parents, you are asked to remain in the auditorium. You will be treated as guests, VIP of course. You will be served your refreshments right here. Thank you.
Music as well. Music.
And some music students as well to remain. Janu.